it does make me feel unattractive.
My worst nightmare is that it pops and gets infected. I have a sebaceous cyst on the end of my nose. It's about the size of a large marble, but to me it feels like I've got something like a tennis ball on the end of my nose. I can see red veins going through it. I think it glows like a Bleacher beacon. If I'd never had it, I'd be enjoying my life a lot more. I feel like an 80-year-old because I don't go anywhere, I don't do anything. Got ya! Mwah. Rosie's my granddaughter, she's 2. She spends quite a lot of time here. I'd love to take her up to the park, to the play barns, but I don't. I sit in the house and play with her, or I play with her in the garden. She's my world, and I just want to be a proper granny.
I think Jo's gorgeous, but I don't think she sees the same thing when she looks in the mirror. I feel that Jo's locking herself away.
I sometimes look at Steve and think, I don't know why you're with me. It's because I feel so unattractive. I just want this nightmare to come to an end.
Hiya, Jo. Hi there, come on in, I'm Dr. Emma. Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Come and have a seat, Jo.
Thank you.
So tell me what you've come along with today.
I've got a lump on the end of my nose.
Oh dear, and how long has that been there?
3 or 4 years.
So imagine of all the places to get it, you get it right on the end of your nose.
Only me. I went to my GP, they told me it was a sebaceous cyst.
Uh-huh. And you've got makeup on it now?
Yes.
Because from where I'm sitting, your nose looks pretty straight. It looks like you've got a slight little upturn to the nose, but it looks in proportion, but that's different to what your normal
nose is. I've usually got what they call a Roman nose.
Uh-huh.
It's totally changed shape. It doesn't normally turn up at the end at all.
I mean, it turns up in quite a nice way at the end. It's quite cute. You don't agree?
No.
And do you think it's still growing?
Yeah, definitely. Gets me down, gets me really down. It's really knocked my confidence. I don't do social things very much. Sort of shy away from them.
So you think that if you didn't have this on the end of your nose, that you would be able to go and do all of those things?
I think I would go out more, yeah, definitely.
Quite often whenever we come to removing things, it would leave a scar behind instead of a lump that's there.
Yeah, I'd rather have a scar than a lump any day. It's, yeah, I just don't like the lump. Don't like the shape of it. It's not me. To me, it feels like a big clown nose. It's really affected my confidence.
Oh, dear.
I don't go out of the house much.
Because you feel embarrassed?
Yeah.
That's a bit of a shame. Mm. OK. Well, you know I'm really nosy, so I want to get really nosy and have a close-up look at this. Is that OK?
Yeah, that's fine.
Let's go.
Yep.
Moddy, can you put the paper on the bed, please? Because Joe's coming in. If we just prep for a mini minor ops kit, it's just on the nose.
Yep.
Jo, do you want to come through?
Yeah.
You just sit on the edge of the bed and face me, if that's okay, just while we have a little look at this area on the nose. You can actually see the angle from the edge where it's almost like a little ski slope heading up.
Yep.
It's a bit redder and it's definitely softer on the very end of it. And it feels like there's a very well-defined cyst in there. This is definitely a sebaceous cyst, which is a gathering of keratin material inside a balloon-like sac. This cyst is right on the very end of the nose. So this is a bit trickier because we've got to think about how we want to place the scar. My plan is to make an incision down the middle of it, take out a bit of the extra skin that's there because this skin's had a chance to stretch and she doesn't really want loose skin over the nose, and then we'll pop it out and then suture this area up again.
Just pop your head up for me and relax it back down. Snug as a bug in a rug, Jo.
You all right?
Mm-hmm.
You excited?
Yes and no.
Now, I am just going to put the anaesthetic in that makes everything go numb. Is that okay?
Yeah.
Well done. So if we make an incision along this little kind of ellipsis shape, it just lets me get in and remove all of the cyst. Also, you've grown a little bit more skin there.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to actually remove a bit of the skin so the skin's not loose. Good. And we're just working our way round to see what's in here.
He's an impressive little
guy. And I can see the cyst wall. And the wall is under quite a lot of tension, which is why you could see the skin starting to stretch on the surface of it. Oh, there we go, it's already popped. Very delicate little cyst wall. I think what we'll do is we will squeeze this. Oh, look, it's coming out.
I love it.
Okay, that feels good.
Ooh, easy.
And there's the cyst wall.
Oh.
Have you ever seen one quite as white and shiny as that? Like, it's pretty lovely. Looks like a tooth, it's so white.
Nasal tip there.
Perfect, thank you.
We're going to give your nose a little nose tuck.
I'm really glad that we did it this way and took that redundant skin, because otherwise it would have been quite baggy on the surface.
And you can see the shape of the nose has just come back.
Yeah, gone straight down. Yeah. Although I do have to say, Jo, I quite liked your nose as well before. But it looks perfect now. You're going to hear a buzzing sound, okay? So sorry about that. It's got a bit of a funky smell with it as well. That just seals off any little blood vessels. Otherwise, if it's bleeding, it's just going to gather in that space that we've created. So I'm putting some stitches on the inside so that that holds everything close together. We want to get this just aligned absolutely perfectly, because the only thing that Jo's going to remember me by is what her scar looks like. So what we're trying to do is create a ridge in the skin, because then what happens is as the skin contracts, it will flatten down and you'll have a nice flat scar, rather than if you close it flat, you might end up with a dipped scar. Perfect. Do you want to see it, Jo?
Yeah. Oh, God, you can see the shape now, can't you?
Yeah, just straight away.
That's great. Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Oh, it's absolutely what I was hoping for. I've got my Roman nose back. I hated it before, but then when the cyst came, I hated it even more. So now I'm going to enjoy my Roman nose.
You don't know what you got until it's gone. Lucky we give it back to you.
So we've just finished Jo's nose, and I'm so, actually rhymed, we just finished Jo's nose. So it popped out really nicely. It was quite a decent size actually, but it all came away very, very cleanly. So hopefully she enjoys her new nose. You can actually even see it through the bandage, the fact that the nose is a different shape.
Oh my God, yeah.
Yeah, really can.
Yeah. Oh, that's amazing. Thank you so much.
Pleasure, love doing it.
I'm absolutely delighted I came to see Dr. Emma. She's done an amazing job on my nose. Just looking forward to going out anywhere. I don't care where I go. I'm really looking forward to being me again.
Look at me.
Look at my nose! Life's really good at the moment.
It's just straight. It's amazing.
When I used to look in the mirror, I used to check it out, make sure it weren't red, can you see any yellow bits on it? Now I just look in the mirror and I'm like trying to find my scar. I've got more confidence now. I sent my granddaughter out.
One,
two,
three.
And it's amazing.
Boom.
Hi, Rosie.
It's not so much about how it looks, it's about the confidence that it's given you back, really.
Hooray!
It's about the you shining through from the inside.